That's right, Tom. And favorability ratings can be tricky, especially in the summertime when the last thing on a lot of voters' minds is politics. But for well-known candidates, it's a good barometer on where they stand with their messages. But it also gives the lesser-knowns an idea of how much work they still have to do.
Starting with the unopposed Democrat in the Senate race, Paul Hodes has parlayed his term in Congress into a favorability rating of 32%, slightly higher than those who view him in a negative light, and 2 points higher than April.
If you have an unfavorable, or if you have a low favorability ratings, what you typically have to do is bring down the favorability ratings of your opponents. It's difficult to boost yours back up in a short period of time. And I think that's been Hodes' strategy, particularly against Kelly Ayotte.
And it may be working. Following weeks of attack ads, Kelly Ayotte has seen her favorability drop from 38% in April to 36% now. But take a look at the unfavorable rating for Ayotte. That has more than doubled to 27% since April.
We could say that a lot of the advertisements that Hodes has been running that have been very critical of Ayotte seem to be boosting her unfavorabilities.
Both Republicans Jim Bender and Bill Binney entered the race as virtual unknowns, but a series of ads by both campaigns have boosted their favorability and unfavorability since April. But in both columns, the eye-popping number is the percentage of those who are undecided or don't know the candidates. 60% in the Binney poll, and for Bender, a whopping 72%. And the dog days of summer are tough times to build name recognition.
During the month of August, it's a dead zone. It's the Bermuda Triangle of politics. Voters they're not paying attention to politics. They're on vacations. So it's very difficult to generate much momentum.
Ovid LaMontagne faces the same challenge. Poor fundraising numbers have translated to little movement in his favorability ratings for the former gubernatorial candidate. Even so, Smith says now is the time for all the campaigns to get organized for when voters do start paying attention.
Everything has to be in place for Labor Day and the beginning of the school year for those campaigns to turn on the switch and really sprint for those last 2 weeks.
These numbers come from a random sampling of a little more than 500 New Hampshire voters, but there is a telling number that will resonate with all the campaigns. At the end of July, less than 2 months before the primaries, only 15% of those polled say that they have definitely decided who they're voting for. Josh McKelvin, WMUR News 9.